2013, an industry organization was created with one clear objective, which was to end with passwords as our main means for authentication to digital services. Passwords are as old as the internet itself. We have been extremely dependent on passwords, and it has been the main mechanism, the unavoidable mechanism, for authentication to digital services ever since. Yet, neither service providers nor end users are happy with passwords. They are not user convenient, they are not secure. So FIDO Alliance gathered all these companies around the table in order to take their brain power and their technological capacities in order to define, design, and deploy a new solution for authentication that could, for good, replace passwords. So passkeys are the tangible result of 10 years of work of the FIDO Alliance. And it is a tangible result in the sense that it is what we all as users are going to be exposed to, what we will be using in the future when we will be accessing any type of digital services instead of introducing a username and a password. Over these 10 years, the members of the FIDO Alliance have been working on the specification first, but then more than that, they have been working on the implementation in the respective products that they are bringing to market of this technology so that we can leverage it moving forward. In particular, there are three companies that are very important in this effort that endorse the technology, and these are Apple, Google, and Microsoft. Why Apple, Google, and Microsoft in particular? Because together they cover the platforms, the operating system for all the laptops and computers on one side with Microsoft Windows and Mac OS, and on the other side for smartphones and tablets with Android and iOS. The fact that they have endorsed this technology and they have decided to support it on their platforms ensures ubiquity for FIDO technology. It's available, it's going to be available on all computers and all smartphones and all the platforms that we use on a daily basis in order to access these digital services, and this is very important. Furthermore, they've done something more, these three companies. They have agreed on a common name for this technology, and this name is passkeys, and even a common logo that they are going to use to make it familiar for end users at large. And they have started to advertise publicly about the technology. They issued a joint PR in the month of May, and in the months that followed, they have been deploying information about the availability of this technology for developers that now have to implement it on their respective services so that we can all benefit from them very, very soon. So the goal is that passkeys become available for access to all of our digital services. And that means that the way they have been defined has privileged a good user experience rather than putting a high bar on security. Clearly, there are services that require a higher end of security than the bar that is set by passkeys. Passkeys are undoubtedly much more secure than traditional passwords, but yet may not be at the level that is required by certain industries, and in particular for financial services. It may not be compliant with regulations that are imposed for certain industries like the financial one. So that is why the challenge for financial institutions is to figure out how to leverage this technology that now becomes available and that certainly is beneficial for their end users and beneficial for themselves, while at the same time setting up the measures on top of passkeys to achieve the level of security that they require. So the arrival of passkeys is inevitable. They are already here, they are already available on Apple platforms, on iOS and on Mac OS, and they will be available on Android platforms, on Chrome OS, as well as on Windows by the end of the year, beginning of next year. What it means for financial institutions is that they have to rethink what is their approach to authentication to their digital services in order to, on one side, take advantage of all the good features, the improved security that passkeys bring compared to passwords, and on the other side, identify what are the additional security measures that they have to put on top of passkeys in order to reach the level of security that is required by themselves on one side and required by the financial industry regulators that they need to comply with. So Thales has been working for over 30 years helping financial institutions achieve their goals related to security for services at large and in particular for digital services. At this particular moment where we are going to find ourselves in front of a transition of technology, our ID Cloud service is designed in order to facilitate that transition in the smoothest way possible. And on top of that, ID Cloud is going to allow financial institutions complement the security provided by passkeys with additional measures that will allow them to ensure compliance with financial regulations and, in general, achieve the level of security that they demand for their services.